Hello, I am CA Sahil Garu. As you already know, 1st Feb is the date where we expect the budget this year. And this year's budget is specifically more challenging because of the pandemic situation. The economy is in a condition of a V-shaped recovery this year. And the GST collection of December 2020 was one of the record highest collection, where they have collected more than 1.1 lakh crore in just December 2020, which is a very good sign for the economy. Now, this budget, I think, is very challenging for the finance minister because of the pandemic situation. They need more spending. People need to spend more because there have been loss of jobs, etc. So government should come up with such measures which should increase the spending by the citizens. Like, for example, as far as income tax is concerned, there is a section called as ATC, where you get a deduction of up to 1.5 to 2 lakhs where you spend in certain securities and things. If the government increases that limit by bringing up, say, some COVID-related bond or some COVID-related securities, people may spend in those securities with intention to get more deduction, and government in turn will get that money in its hands so as to spend on various infrastructure projects and any kind of spending that is required. As far as COVID-related measures are concerned, I think government should not increase the tax burden further on the people who are already paying income tax. In India, there are already 4.5% people who pay income tax. So rather than increasing the tax burden only on those 4.5% by levying a COVID cess or COVID surcharge, government should in turn bring up some COVID bonds or something like that, where people will get deduction by spending into those bonds. For example, there is a section called as 54EC, where a person can get a deduction for capital gain where he invest up to 50 lakhs in some NHA or RDCA bonds. Since the state governments and central governments have already brought up various measures where real estate is given a boost, there are huge capital gain cases coming this year. So government can come up with a COVID bond where a person, if invests more than 50 lakhs in such bonds, he will get an additional deduction. So that will be a deduction for him, and government can get a lump sum money of, say, 25-50 lakhs from each person who gets a capital gain, and that will boost up the money collection for the government. Secondly, there is a section called as ATIDA, where government has given a boost to the housing sector by, and the last date of it I think is 31st March 2020. So in this budget, to further increase that boost or increase the period where the eligible projects can run into, government should, I think, increase the time limit to 31st March 2021. It should increase the time limit by further year so as to increase the period where the affordable projects and eligible projects can run into. As far as GST is concerned, GST, by far the law is fine and everything is running fine, but the implementation has seen many challenges. So in this budget, government should take such measures where the implementation process of GST shall be streamlined. For example, I have heard that in this past year, government has come up with more than 300 circulars and notifications, but that has such frequent and often circulars and notifications brings up various challenges for the taxpayers and the tax practitioners. Such number, more than 300 number of circulars, is a big thing. So government should avoid that, and to streamline the implementation process, they should come up with some new measures where there should be more simplicity in GST implementation. Secondly, there is the government is under section 47, the government is charging late fees for a per day delay in GST return filing. Now, there is also such late fee concept in TDS, where a person who is required to file TDS returns has to pay 200 rupees per day late fee where there is a delay. But the big difference here is, in case of TDS, if there is a delay, that is purely the default of the tax filer, the return filer. But as far as GST is concerned, the system itself as of now is not a robust system, because of which the delay most of the times might be because of the system and not because of the taxpayer. So I think, especially in this pandemic period where there are many administrative issues faced by the filers, this late fee can be waived. The government can think of waiving the late fee or giving some amnesty to it, or at least giving some grace period of say 10 days beyond the original time limit of filing the return. So that will help the taxpayers to save on the late fees, because that late fee, in addition to the implementation hurdles, is a big problem for the taxpayers. Again, coming into income tax, I think government can bring up an important thing, which I think government should bring, is that government should bring up some amnesty scheme for trusts. In India, there are lakhs of trusts who do not file their income tax returns because they do not have a 12A registration or they do not have such a system. But if government brings up an amnesty scheme, whereas the delay of 12A registration is condoned and one-time tax payment is allowed, many trusts shall file their returns and shall continue to file their returns. So that will help a one-time huge tax collection from the trusts by the government. So that amnesty will prove as a big boost from the tax collection angle, and which will continue throughout the years, because those trusts will then continue to file their returns regularly.